गुड आफ्टरनून
गुड
सर।
आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
गुड आफ्टरनून
गुड आफ्टरनून सर।
ओके सो आफ्टर 5 मिनट्स योर क्लास विल स्टार्ट। ओके लेट अदर्स जॉइन फर्स्ट देन फर्स्ट वी विल सॉल्व द प्रीवियस न्यूमेरिकल दैट आई लेफ्ट। ओके द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 देन वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर ट्रांसफॉर्मर पोर्शन। ओके दैट्स द ओपन सर्किट टेस्ट एंड द शॉर्ट सर्किट टेस्ट एंड हाउ टू डू दैट राइट।
ओके सर।
ओके Good afternoon again. Okay, is the screen visible? Everyone, please check whether the screen is
yes,
visible.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. So, किसी को नींद भी आ रहा है क्या? इतना लो वोल्टेज में तुम लोग रन कर रहे हो आज? अरे क्या करें? आज टाइम मिल गया इसीलिए। Okay, fine. So, जिसको भी नींद आ रहा है मुंह में पानी देके उसके बाद आके बैठो। ठीक है, आज न्यूमेरिकल पूरा सॉल्व करके उसके बाद ट्रांसफॉर्मर पे जाएंगे। ठीक। ओके सो सिंस द स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू आई एम डायरेक्टली गोइंग टू हियर। ओके फाइन। सो व्हाट वाज द न्यूमेरिकल हियर? 1-2 एम्पियर सोर्स इज हियर। ओके then 115 ohm I think, right? Okay, everyone please check whether the drawing is right or not. Okay, 15, this one is 2 ampere, next here another resistance is there, one voltage source of 6 volt, correct? Here it is 6 volt, and what is the value of this resistance?
6 ohm.
Okay. Then here I think 3 ohm is there, na?
Yes, sir.
3 ohm. Okay. And here another voltage source is present, and its amount is magnitude.
It's 8 volt.
And magnitude is 8 volt. Okay. Here there is nothing. Okay. Here only 3 ohm is present, and here is another voltage source of 8 volt. Okay, is the polarity correct? Please check.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this is your 8 volt, there is 3 ohm. Okay, so and the process you have to follow is Norton rule. Okay, that is Norton's rule. Okay, so what is the basic idea of Norton rule? That you have to omit this resistance and this portion will be shorted, correct? So I am redrawing this circuit. This is your 2 ampere because none of you solved this numerical correct. Okay, there is no problem. I will show you how to solve this kind of numerical. Okay, and this is your 6 ohm. Here it is positive polarity, this one is negative. Or yahan pe 3 ohm. Then this is your shorted path. Okay, and some of you had drawn this figure at this point. Okay, here you did something wrong, that you have omitted this voltage source also with the resistance. Okay, that was basically wrong, because in Norton theorem it states that tumko sirf the load resistance ko omit karna hai. You have to omit the load resistance only, not the voltage source. Clear? So here I will keep the voltage source as it is. Okay, and this is your current source. This is your short circuit current that you have to calculate basically. Now it is 6 volt. This one is 6 ohm. Okay, this is 15. This one is 2 ampere. Okay, and this one is 3 ohm. Clear? Now look, can I redraw this circuit like this? Please check. I am redrawing this circuit. Can I redraw this type of the circuit, above circuit like this? Yes or no? Please check. Can I draw like this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now we are going to follow the source conversion rule. Okay. Since you already know how to convert. So this portion I am going to convert first. Okay. So here one voltage source will be present and one resistance will be in series. Okay. And what will be the value of the voltage source? 15 into 2. That means 30 volt. Clear? 30 volt. Now, this resistance I need to put again here. Okay. Another voltage source also here. This is 6 volt. This one is 6 ohm. This one is 15 ohm. Okay. This one is 15 ohm. Now, here as it is, you have to keep the 3 ohm in its own place, and here remember the polarity, because this one is very important. Okay, because see here polarity is negative, first one, this is negative, this one is positive. Okay, so at this point what is the voltage? -8, isn't it? At this point the voltage is -8. Okay, now we will apply the either nodal analysis or mesh analysis. It's up to you. Okay. Now, and here ISC current will flow. Correct. Now, see, I am following the nodal analysis at this point, at A point.
Sir.
Okay. Yes.
Sir, why here is -8? Please, sir, repeat again.
Because look, here the voltage polarity is opposite, na? In case of 8 volt, check.
Yes, sir.
That's why, because negative is here. So, the topmost polarity will be -8.
Yes, sir, I got it.
Okay, fine. Now look, I want to do the nodal analysis at the point A. So, at A, applying the nodal analysis, okay, nodal analysis, 30 volt, okay, here 6 volt is of opposite polarity, so 30 minus 6 and this -8, okay, of -8 divided by total resistance is 15 plus 6, that means 21. Okay, so this one is your input current and equals to what is your output current? That is -8 divided by 3 plus ISC. Now, is it okay or not? Or do I need to repeat again?
Sir, repeat again.
Okay, fine. So if I need to repeat again, forget this minus 8. First, here you are having some problem. Okay, I am assuming this voltage is V. No problem here, I think. Okay, is there any problem?
No, sir.
Okay, now look, here the voltage is 30 volt, right? Here the voltage is 6 volt. So what is the total voltage in this branch? First, here the voltage is 30 volt. Okay. Check the polarity. Positive, negative. Next case, the polarity is just opposite. Here it is plus, this one is minus 6 volt. So what is your net voltage here in this branch? The net voltage is 24 volt. Is that concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that concept I just applied here. Look here. 30 minus 6. Okay. Clear now? Next. अगर हम लोग यहाँ पे नोडल एनालिसिस लगाते तो इसमें हम क्या लिख पाते? देखो, 24 वोल्ट माइनस वोल्टेज वी डिवाइडेड बाय द लाइंस रेजिस्टेंस. ओके, सो दैट इज 21. क्लियर? ओके, नेक्स्ट आउटपुट करंट क्या होगा? वी बाय 3 प्लस आईएससी. इज दिस इक्वेशन ओके टू यू?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now what is the value of V here? Minus 8, isn't it? The voltage of V is minus 8. So in that V place, write minus 8. So that's how we are getting this equation. Is this okay? Is it fine or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So now calculate the ISC value. Okay, so calculate the ISC value. You will see that the ISC value, you will get almost, I think, 2 point something ampere. Okay, almost it's, let me check, it is 4.19 ampere. Okay. Solve this one. Okay, solve this one in your own copy with me, because I am solving this. You also solve this in your own copy. Then only you can understand the process. Okay, so this is your IA 4.19 ampere. Now redraw the Norton equivalent circuit, right? So in Norton equivalent circuit, what will I write? This is your ISC. Value is 4.19 ampere, correct? Then in parallel, this resistance value will be the Norton equivalent resistance or Thevenin equivalent resistance. Do you remember that? Yaad hai ya bhul gaye?
Yes, sir.
मतलब याद है. ओके, देन क्विकली टेल मी व्हाट इज द थेवेनिन इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस. टेल मी द थेवेनिन इक्विवेलेंट रेजिस्टेंस. यू हैव 1 मिनट टाइम. विद इन दैट टाइम कैलकुलेट इट एंड टेल मी. Have you solved? क्या वो आंसर निकला या नहीं निकला अभी तक? देखो, ड्यूरिंग द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ दिस RTH, what you have to do? You have to open circuit the current source and short circuit the voltage source, right? So redraw the circuit like this. First, there is one current source. Okay, so it will be open circuited. 15 ohm will be here. Okay, then here 6 ohm. Next, voltage source. So it will be shorted. Next, in parallel 3 ohm, right? Here another voltage source is present, so it will also be shorted. And you have to look from this side. So what is the RTH value? That is simple. 3 parallel 21. Okay. 3 into 21 divided by 24. So this will be 21 by 8. Now tell me, what is the value of this fraction?
2.6.
Yes?
2.6.
No, not 6. It will be 6 to 5, I think. 2.625.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. 2.625. See, it is not at all that much tough, the calculation of RTH. Okay. Only you have to keep the current source open circuited and voltage source short circuited. That's all. Bus. Okay. Next. So in place of Rn, what should I write? 2.625. Right. And in place of R, that is our unknown value. Correct. So now, what rule I need to use? Current divider rule, right? So IR value will be, what is your initial total current? 4.19 into, I need to calculate the current through R. So here 2.625 will be present, divided by R plus 2.625. So if you calculate this numerator, you will find that value is 11 divided by R plus, that is almost 10.998 almost. Okay, if you check,
yes,
10.998, so it is almost 11, you can write it, right? So it is R plus 2.625. So this is the ultimate answer. Okay. Aap agar koi confusion hai to batao isme. Then I will again repeat. Otherwise, I will move to the transformer.
Sir, please show the slide. Next slide.
See, this one is the previous one. First, where ISC was calculated. Okay. And okay, take the snapshot if you forget.
Yes, sir.
And this one is the next one, the calculation of IR, because this type of numerical can be given in the exam, where R value they will keep unknown. Okay. And then they will ask you ki ye R ka value kya hoga, taki ye value of IR becomes maximum. Okay, this type of question can be asked. So you have to calculate this equation first, then apply the other rules. Clear? So the class test questions were discussed fully. So I just stop this screen sharing here. And we will directly go to the transformer part. Okay. Where is that? Here is the impedance transformer. Okay. So let's just do one quick recapitulation of what we did in previous class. Okay. Because I know some of you already forgot this. Okay. Dimag se ud gaya maximum ka. So what we actually did in this transformer case, first, what is transformer? That is one static machine, okay, or static device Okay, what is transformer? One static device working at constant frequency, frequency equals to constant, okay, where with frequency constant, power transfer is also constant, okay, and it is used to keep the voltage level, okay, from primary to secondary. And we also get to know this equation, that E1 by E2 equals to V1 by V2 equals to NP by NS, or you can say N1 by N2 in place of NP by NS. Okay, N1 by N2, that you can say. Okay, so that's the basic definition of transformer. Okay, and next, what we discussed? We discussed how many types of transformer operation is there. Okay, the transformer may be operated as step up, okay, or it can be used as step down transformer. Okay, and two types of transformer were there, okay, as per their usage. First one is distribution type. First one is the distribution type, and second one is power transformer. Okay, in your locality, the transformer you are observing that was mounted on a pole, so that was basically the distribution type transformer. Okay, and this distribution type is mainly step down transformer. Okay, because in from the thermal power plants, the power, the voltage level was almost 11 kV, or it may be almost 660 volt, okay, 440 volt. So when we want to use that voltage, we need to step down, because our at home we are using 440 volt RMS, 440 volt peak, and 230 volt RMS. Okay, so two types of transformer: distribution type and power transformer. Clear? Now, then we discussed the impedance transformer. What is the meaning of impedance transformer? Impedance transformer means, suppose we added one resistance in the primary. Okay, one resistance in the primary. So I can draw this system where the secondary is, in secondary there is no resistance or no impedance. Okay, so this transformer can be redrawn like this. Okay, this one side is primary, this is your secondary. So I can redraw like this. Okay, suppose this is your Z1 and another resistance is here. This is your secondary, this is primary. So this value is Z1 dash. Okay, so what is this value of Z1 dash? Z1 dash is the resistance or impedance referred to the secondary. Okay, here the original impedance is in primary. Okay, when we want to convert that impedance into secondary, that is called the referred to secondary. Okay, or with respect to the secondary. Similarly, suppose in secondary there is one impedance or resistance and you have to calculate with respect to primary. Okay, or referred to primary. So that is the conversion process. So that conversion process will be done using this equation. Okay, you can use this equation, or if you cannot remember this, you can easily calculate it. Okay, how? Because we already know that V1 by V2 equals to k, and since power is constant, okay, power is constant, so I can write that V1, okay, that is I1 equals to V2 into I2. So V1 by V2 I can write as I2 by I1 equals to K, right? So here I can also write that I2 by I1 equals to K. Now I am writing this V1 by I1 equals to Z1, right? V2 by I2, okay? V2 by I2 equals to Z2, correct? Now divide it. Fine. So I can write V1 by V2 into I2 by I1, right? I can also write here Z1 by Z2. So this value will be K square equals to Z1 by Z2. Okay. So whatever value is known to you, put that value, you can easily calculate it. That is the basic funda of this topic, impedance transformer. Okay. Now, next one is the no load operation. Now, what is the meaning of no load operation? No load operation means in secondary, I am not giving any load. There is no resistance, only that is open circuit. Okay, that is the meaning of no load operation. Now, in no load operation, what is your flux value that is calculated here? That is nothing different. Already it was discussed earlier. Okay. Now this no load operation is almost similar with the open circuit test that you already performed in lab. Okay, so in no load operation, what was done? In no load operation, the high voltage side is kept. Here, this is your transformer. Okay. Now, the primary voltage here is V1, okay, the main flux is phi, and secondary voltage is V2, clear? Now, this here, the applied voltage is here, this is in this side, okay, this side I am keeping open, okay, so here I will put another meter, okay, to check what is the voltage, right? Open circuit voltage. So that is the no load operation, and you will see that only one reading was there where you had calculated one source current, that means that is called no load current, okay, that is called the I0, okay, and another one is called the magnetizing current IM, and another current is there that is called the core component of the current. Okay, now what is the meaning of this type of current? What is the meaning? Right? Meaning is, in primary we are giving V voltage, okay, and in this primary current is flowing, that is called the no load current, okay, and there is one power loss, and if there is one active power loss, that means what? That means in that transformer core there is one resistance, okay, so through that resistance the current is flowing, and that current is called the IW, okay, and another magnetizing current is there. Now what is the meaning of this magnetizing current? The core of the transformer is assumed like this type of structure. Okay, it is assumed like this kind of structure. Okay, it is basically a parallel combination of one inductor and one resistor. Now, why this kind of connection is thought? Because look, here I0 is flowing through the main circuit, right? Since secondary is open, so no current will flow through this. No current will flow. So that means what? Through this path, no current will flow, right? So I0 will only be divided into two components, okay? Another one is core component, that is written as IW, okay? Another one is called the magnetizing component, that is passing through this inductor, okay? This is called the IM. Now, this current is very important. This IM current is very important because this current is the sole reason for the creation of this flux. Okay, this is the main flux phi M. Now, this phi M is created due to the flowing of this IM amount of current. That's why this magnetizing component is very important. Okay, this is called the magnetizing component. Now, what is the cos theta? What is the cos theta definition? Can you tell me what is the cos theta definition? Richa Kumari, are you present?
Yes, sir. Power factor.
Yes, what is the definition of the power factor? How to calculate that? Do you remember?
So active power, current power.
So see, here active power is, I didn't calculate, here reactive power is not also here. So, see, always remember that, yes, active power, reactive power, that angle is called, the cosine of that angle is called the power factor. Yes, it is absolutely correct. But when voltage and current is present, the angle between that voltage and current is the power factor angle. And cosine of that angle is the power factor also. Because I already had shown you that impedance triangle, power factor triangle, voltage triangle, all those angles are already same every time, isn't it? So here, where voltage and current is known, the angle between that voltage and current, if present, then cosine of that angle will be calculated as a power factor of that system, right? So here, look, what is the voltage here in primary? V1, okay? And what is the current flowing through the circuit? That is I0. And in between that, angle is your theta 0. So, if you take the cos theta 0, it will give you the no load power factor, okay? Here this circuit is called no load operation, or you can say the open circuit test operation of the transformer. Okay, so in that open circuit test, if you open your lab copy, you will see that this phasor diagram you had drawn. Okay, and there is one angle theta 0, that is in between the voltage and current. That angle, the cosine of that angle, is called the power factor. And normally in open circuit case, In open circuit case, this power factor is very low. Okay, it is very low. Right? It is very low amount. Now, so this is the no load operation. Okay, and do you remember in no load operation which part, which side? The high voltage side is kept open or low voltage side is kept open? Quickly tell me. Which one is correct? High voltage side is kept open or low voltage side is kept open? Vishnu Sharma, are you present? Vishnu Sharma, are you present?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Then tell me which side is kept open in transformer open circuit case?
So high voltage side.
And in short circuit case? In short circuit case, check your lab copy and then tell which side is kept open. I will not answer this. Okay, you have to tell me. In open circuit case, which side is kept open, and in short circuit case of the transformer, which side is shorted? Quickly, anyone, check your lab copy and tell me. Okay, so that you have to find out. Okay, that's your homework for today. You have to find out which side is kept open and which side is kept short circuited. Okay, in open circuit and short circuit case. Now, quickly complete this open circuit calculation. That I0 is nothing but the root under of Im square plus Iw square. Okay, here. And this theta value you can calculate, theta 0 equals to tan inverse Im by Iw. And this Iw value, that is the core component, core loss component of the current. Okay. And from the open circuit case, from the open circuit test of the transformer, we get to know the core loss of the transformer. Okay, core loss of the transformer, and this core loss comprises of two types of loss. Okay, another one, first one is hysteresis loss and next one is eddy current loss. Right, so that's in the open circuit case. Right. Now, if you put this theta 0 close to 90, then the no load power factor angle will be close to 0 because cos 90 is 0. So, the minimum value of this theta 0 must be kept beyond the 45 degree every time it is kept. Okay, if you calculate, if you see your calculation, your own calculation, then you will see the same case. Okay, your power factor is low in open circuit condition. Right. Now, that is written here, when a transformer is connected to a supply, there actually occurs the eddy current loss and hysteresis loss. Okay, what is and in this hysteresis loss, that is basically the vibration. Okay. And in the iron core and appear as heat. And why heat is generated? because of that resistance that is assumed to be in parallel with that winding. Okay, due to that current flow IW into this resistance, the heat is generated, right? So that heat loss occurs. Okay, now the power is taken from AC supply at primary, and the no load current component IM is used in magnetizing the core. Okay, and the current IM lags behind the applied voltage by pi by 2, because see here it is the applied voltage and this one is IM. So which one is here lagging or leading? See, IM is lagging by angle 90 degree with respect to V1, or you can say that V1 is leading by 90 degree with respect to IM. Okay, now the product of IM and V1 is called the reactive power, right? Now therefore the input reactive power, input active power and the reactive power at no load are here, that P0 is the active power and Q0 is the reactive power. So what is active power? V1 into IW, because that IW is the current flowing through the resistance, right? So I can say that VI cos theta 0 is your active power loss and VI sin theta 0 is your reactive power loss. Okay, so that's for today. Okay, so in next class we will discuss this on load operation and then the short circuit condition. Okay, so everyone give your attendance in the chat box, and if you have any query regarding the class test or the topic I discussed, you can ask.
So if open circuit test,
yes
sir.
Yes.
So in open circuit test, high voltage side is always kept
yes,
open.
Sir.
Yes, yes sir. High voltage side is always kept open.
Open.
Yes, all sir. Of you are telling that, sir, high voltage side, but you are not at all confident whether your answer is correct or not. Okay. So whatever answer you are telling, you are saying, if you know that correctly, then tell me confidently that yes sir, that will happen. Okay, I may be wrong. I may be wrong. You have already seen that in numericals sometimes you are correct, I did somewhere wrong, so that happens. Okay, so whatever you know you are confirmed, then tell me with full confidence. Okay, so that's for today. Okay, so thank you everyone.
Thank you sir.
Thank you.
Thank you sir.
Thank you sir.
Thank you sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you sir.
Thank you.